We start in Indianapolis and the search for answers after that mass shooting that killed 8 people at a FedEx facility. So much pain after yet another rampage with loved ones of those who died speaking out this morning. Will Carr is in Indianapolis with the very latest. Will, good morning to you.
Good morning, Whit. Overnight, authorities came out and said that the alleged shooter legally purchased 2 assault rifles last year, the rifles that he used in the attack on the FedEx behind me. It comes after the FBI interviewed that suspect last year and took a separate rifle out of his house, leaving some to question if more should have been done to prevent this shooting.
This morning, Indianapolis is mourning the 8 lives lost. Margie Joel was killed working at a FedEx hub, one of the largest in the world. She was an aunt, a mother, and a grandmother. This weekend, her granddaughter got engaged.
No, I just saw her this week. Like, it doesn't feel real. I posted her picture everywhere because she is not going to be a statistic. She has a story. She's a person.
Joel's family waited for more than 12 hours, only to find out that their worst fears had come true.
We were looking in hospitals everywhere. We couldn't find her. No one could sleep all night. We just waited all day. We were shivering, shaking, just hoping nothing happened to her.
Joel and 3 other victims were active members of Indianapolis's Sikh community. Indianapolis police confirming overnight the alleged shooter bought the 2 guns used in the attack legally in July and September of 2020, despite Indiana's red flag law. This after previously being on authorities' radar.
We want accountability, but right now is not the time. When one of our own passes away, the whole Sikh community grieves with them.
Carly Smith was 19 and just started working at FedEx.
She was the mini me. She was literally my lookalike. She was, if the kids needed something and I couldn't do it or I wasn't available, go get your sister. She can help you with it.
She's one of 8 loved ones who were taken from their families without the chance to say goodbye. Chaplain Matt Barnes, a family friend of slain 19-year-old Samaria Blackwell, remembers Blackwell as an athlete who always had a smile on her face.
On the court, she'd put a mouth guard on and be the meanest looking girl out there. Step off the court, she's got this beautiful smile. She just cared about people. And so that was Samaria in a nutshell.
And while friends and family members are still trying to absorb the loss of their loved ones, the alleged shooter's family has released a statement. They say they are devastated. They say they tried to get him help, and they are offering apologies to the victims and their families. Whit.
All right, Will, thank you.
Well, hey there, GMA fans. Robin Roberts here. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Lots of great stuff here. So go on, click the subscribe button right over here to get more of awesome videos and content from GMA every day, anytime. We thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the morning on GMA.